Finn likes his dad to collect him at the airport and bring him home.
Taxi him around.
When he's going to the gym, although he's going down to the gym to do 2 or 3 hours in the gym, he hasn't got the energy to walk to the gym, and he hasn't got the energy to walk home from the gym, so dad has to drive him to the gym and be on standby to get a text to collect him from the gym. My name is Fintan Devitt, and this is Leonie, my wife. We've 5 children. Finn is the second boy of 4 boys, and we have Anne-Marie in the middle. Leonie and I are both from Bray, where we live today, and we've lived here for 38 years. The boys and Anne-Marie all grew up very happy children in this area. Well, as a young Finn, he was always a very happy child. Full of fun, but he lived on the edge as well. Very much into soccer and Gaelic games. From an early stage, showed a lot of interest in wrestling. When he worked in the local supermarket after school, all the money was put to buy wrestling gear. Like, he had every tape, every video, all the figures, rings, everything. Everything was spent on wrestling.
What's left over from my childhood, Power Slam was a magazine that came out once a month, and I would run home from school to the newsagents to get this, and I would read it cover to cover, and it was literally the only thing I would read. This was like my Bible.
When we go to teachers' meetings, they always bring up the little thing about the wrestling, so they all knew that he was into the wrestling. When it came to essays, he was writing about wrestling. And
he was a good student in school. He was behaviour-wise, his reports were always very good, and his art reports were always very good, so very well liked in school.
When he told us early on that he wanted to be a wrestler, we told him to follow his dream. And if that's what he wanted, we supported him all the way.
When we were younger, he was very hands-on with his, I suppose, his own training regime that he started.
I may have been a little bit disobedient.
When me and my other brother Owen, we were very young, he would practice a lot on us.
The powerbomb used to be his favourite.
We had an older couch in this sitting room, and he used to be able to take the base pillows off it, and they'd be laid out on the floor here.
And because he couldn't practice the moves on me, I'd be sent out to keep an eye out to see was my mother coming back.
Yeah, you'd get about 12, 15 powerbombs in a row.
Powerbomb, Razor's Edge, even a good old Davey Boy Smith Power Slam.
I made rings for him and helped him with all his equipment. Put shows together and got lights. Ciarán, our other son, always worked doing the sound and the lighting. And Anne-Marie used to do the door, collect the money at the door from time to time.
I think everybody in this household was always raised to support each other. You know, especially with my chosen kind of dream, it might have been a little bit out there for some people.
Regularly we got phone calls from the school, from the career guidance or teachers that were taking interest in him, and they'd say, Finn is telling us that he wants to be a wrestler, saying you better come down and talk to us. Like, he's not going to be a wrestler. You're going to have to talk to him. He's going to have to find a career. We'd go to the meetings with them and we'd say, no, he's going to be a wrestler. And they'd be amazed.
Just say, well, that's what he wants to do, so let's support him, you know. You know, I'm sure if I wanted to be a postman or a fireman, it would have been the exact same, so I don't see why it should be any different if I want to be a pro wrestler.
When he sets his mind on something, it doesn't matter, he'll follow it, and he'll do everything in his power to try and make sure that it comes to fruition.
Fergal Devitt, just relentless!
Just hard work and determination. And
ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Fergal Devitt!
Getting the opportunity to go to Japan. A lot of people would have shied away from that because he was going to a country that he was never in before. We visited Japan quite a lot and went to a lot of shows.
Yeah, the first time we saw him on the stage in Japan, that was, amazing, because it was the very first time on a big show, so it was brilliant.
I always remember my dad getting really excited, like overly excited. My mum, quite the contrast, was always visually very worried about perhaps possible injuries or, you know, mishaps.
No, I never thought about the danger part of it. Never thought about that. Just, he was happy doing it, so.
You used to get a bit worried when you were ringside in Japan, though, didn't you?
In Japan?
The one at Sumo Arena, it was actually a tag team match. I got knocked out of the ring, and my dad leaned through the fence, and he said, "Come on, get up, you can do it." And in the exact same breath, my mum said, "Oh, are you okay? Will you be okay?" So,
No, I was never worried, Bob.
My name is Finn Balor, and I'm here at NXT because I'm bringing something you've never seen before.
We're very happy that Finn has joined the WWE and has been very successful in it.
Coup de grace! Finn Balor is NXT champion!
We were very happy that he was in America. That's what he wanted, and he was following his dream.
Hello.
It was actually wonderful to see his big billboard outside, and we were blown away. Couldn't believe it.
This is great.
To get down there on the night of the show, everybody, you know, was so good and talking to us about him.
Like he said before me, you raised him right.
Good looking kid too.
But he's don't know where he got it from.
From his mother, of course.
To be in that setting, it was amazing.
Seth Rollins lands on his feet. Balor, though, on his as well. Drives Rollins into the corner. Finn Balor's feeling it.
All of a sudden, there it was happening in front of our eyes.
We've got a new WWE Universal Champion!
It gave me goosebumps. I knew that he was very happy. It was just a dream come true.
And ladies and gentlemen, we begin tonight with breaking news. Last night, Finn Balor suffered a torn labrum, which will require surgery, and he'll be out of action at least 6 months.
I actually knew that he got injured as it happened. And Leonie, on a number of occasions, said to me, "He's in pain." We knew that because we'd watched him so many times at shows that we knew that he wasn't comfortable. I couldn't believe that Finn carried on. He would see the show going on more important than him being treated for an injury. That would be normal for him. Not only himself and us, but everybody around was devastated. Well, following on from his surgery, we stayed with him in Orlando for a couple of weeks. Every day he was so positive. A couple of days after, he said to me, "This isn't the end." He said, "This is only the beginning."
My parents have supported me everywhere I've went. UK to Japan, NXT, from the smallest shows in Ireland in front of like 15, 20 people. It wasn't until the surgery, that's when I really appreciated just how much I needed them there, because, you know, the first 2-3 weeks after the surgery, they were really tough. And I don't think I would have got through it as well as I did without having them there by my side. So I'm very grateful for that.
Leonie and I are very proud of him and how well he's done. All the achievements that he's achieved today.
It hasn't changed him at all. Yeah, I think he just loves to get home, and he's always so happy when he's here and just to chill out. And
good size, yeah. How old was I in that one?
He has a nice few friends and then his brothers and sisters would be always in and out, so he'd see everybody, you know. And he loves his mammy's cooking.
I think it's very important to never forget where you came from. But it's, for me, it's just as important to keep coming back to where I came from to reinforce that.
To see what's going on today with all the cameras and the crew, it kind of brings home exactly how well he's doing and how good he's doing. So it's probably a sign of success. And all we hope is that there is success and future success.